Hi, are you going to buy laptop or computer in near future? Or probably you have one. Then this video is for you. You will get an insight about basic component of computer, what parameters you should be more concerned while buying new computer or upgrading the existing one. Not everyone today knows the basic needed to understand computers. In this video, I will try to give simplified explanation of the most basic concepts. Videos on details on individual component will follow soon. A computer includes hardware, software, and peripheral equipments. Computer hardware includes the physical, tangible part of computer such as central processing unit, motherboard, monitor, keyboard, etc. Most important hardware is the CPU, central processing unit, which is brain of the computer. It is located on a printed electrical circuit called motherboard. CPU is a microchip material that has a billions of microscopic electrical connections on it. Any form of information, words, picture, sounds, numbers can be converted to electric signals that are input to the chip. The electrical connections on the chip, according to a program, processes the information into a new form which becomes the output electric signal from the chip. Everything else in a computer is designed to take human information and convert it to the input electric signals for the chip, or to take the chip's output signals and convert them back to a form that humans can recognize. These other components are called peripherals or just input and output devices. Hardware is typically directed by the software to execute any command or instruction. Computer software or program is non-tangible component of computers. At the lowest level, program consists of machine language. All information for the chip has to be in the form of simple electric signal. Voltage on or voltage high versus voltage off or voltage low. This simple signal is represented by 1 for on or high versus a 0 for off or low in writing programs. Every letter of the alphabet, every number, every color, every location, every sound on computer screen has a code in terms of long sequence of 1s or 0s such as 10111. But software is usually written in high-level programming languages that are easier and more efficient for humans to use than machine language. Therefore, a program, an interpreter or compiler converts the type program into input signal to the chip. The chip combines the input information to create its output signal. System software, or most important software, is operating system. It is like the driver of a car. While it might seem like it's only telling the car what to do, it is in fact also interfacing with the different parts of it, as well as taking new input like map, instruction where to go, etc., and performing these tasks to the best of its ability. An operating system, also known as OS, is the middleman between you and the computer. It creates an environment where the user can interact with the computer in an efficient manner. So there are three major OS which you can consider for your laptop or desktop: Windows, Mac, Linux. In this video, emphasis is on central processing unit, CPU, but after brief description of motherboard. It is the main circuit board of the computer and as such acts as a circulation system. Computer motherboard is a single platform to connect all of the parts of the computer together like CPU, RAM, disk drive, etc. Hence, it is considered as backbone of a computer. Some of the popular manufacturers are Intel, Biostar, Gigabyte, etc. Then comes central processing unit, the brain of the computer, which does all the computing. It is the main microchip in the computer that distributes tasks to all other parts of computer. CPU consists of the control unit, the arithmetic and logic unit, and register. The actual mathematical operation for each instruction is performed by Arithmetic and Logic Unit, ALU in short. It is capable of performing two class of operation, arithmetic and logic, as the name suggests. In general, a CPU executes an instruction by fetching it from memory, using its ALU to perform an operation, and then storing the result to memory. Second component of CPU is Control Unit, CU. It directs the operation of the processor. It tells the computer's memory, ALU, and input and output devices how to respond to the instructions that have been sent to the processor. Most computer resources are managed by CU. Its purpose is to control all of the other elements of the CPU, ensuring that they do what they should, when they should. Third component is registers. It is a special set of small memory cells that can be read and written much more rapidly than the main memory area. It holds intermediate results obtained during program processing. Registers are the memory location that are directly accessible by the processor. Registers are the high-speed accessible storage elements and ranges from 32-bit to 64-bit register. The number of register bits specifies the speed and the power of CPU. For example, a CPU which has a 64-bit register can execute 64-bit instruction. Hence, obviously, more the number of bits of register, more is the speed and power of CPU. Since the 1970s, CPUs have typically been constructed on a single integrated circuit chip called a microprocessor. Everything a computer does is described by instruction of computer programs, and microprocessors carry out these instructions many millions of times a second. Microprocessors have system of buses. These are connection lines used to connect the internal parts of the processor and also leads to external connectors that link the processor to other elements of the computer system. Microprocessor made by Intel Corporation formed the foundation for majority of computers. Until the late 80s, Intel was essentially the only producer of PC microprocessor. Two of the leading competitors are Cyrix and AMD. Now let's see some important defining characteristics of a processor. First one is clock speed. Every microprocessor has an internal clock that regulates the speed at which it executes instructions. The clock speed of CPU governs how fast it executes instruction and is measured in gigahertz. 1 gigahertz equals to 1 billion cycles per second. The faster the clock, the more instruction the CPU will execute each second. Many modern processors have the option to overclock the CPU, which enhances the performance at the expense of the greater thermal output and thus a need for improved cooling. Still very high speed generates enough heat to damage the chip itself. To overcome this, manufacturers are using multiple processors working in parallel on a chip. But clock frequency isn't a complete measure of performance. Efficiency, that is how much work can be done by CPU in each clock cycle, is also important. This is measured in term of instruction per cycle or IPC. A CPU with very high clock frequency but low IPC may not perform as well as a CPU with a lower clock frequency and high IPC. Therefore, second important characteristic of microprocessor is instructions per cycle. Number of bits that can be processed by a processor in a single instruction is called its word size. This is the third parameter for efficiency of microprocessor. Word size determines the amount of RAM that can be accessed at one go. First commercial microprocessor, Intel 4004, was a 4-bit processor. Bit is the smallest unit of storage. It stores just a 0 or 1. Currently, most microprocessors use 32-bit or 64-bit architecture. Fourth component is cache memory. Fast access to memory is important to PC processor, and that's what your cache is for. Waiting for data to come in from system memory can make your CPU inefficient. The CPU registers hold the data actually being used in calculations and compromise the fastest memory. The next fastest are caches. This CPU cache has the advantage of faster access than off-chip memory and increases the processing speed of the system. Fifth parameter is number of cores. Modern PC processors are multi-core. A multi-core processor is a single chip that contains more than one microprocessor core. Each core is as fully functional as the others. Each core can simultaneously execute processor instruction in parallel. This effectively multiplies the processor's potential performance by the number of cores. All these parameters decide the speed and efficiency of your computer. Hope you liked this video. Thanks for watching.